Most of us fall into one or two camps regarding money. We either ignore it and feel guilty, or we obsess over financial details by arguing interest rates and geopolitical risk without taking action. Both options lead to the same results: none. Hello everyone and welcome to Avid Wisdom. Here is the summary of the book called I'll Teach You to Be Rich by Ramit Sethi. Before we continue, please make sure you subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you never miss an update. Hit the like button and like our Facebook page. Link is in the description below. I Will Teach You to Be Rich lays out the step-by-step process of mastering your personal finances. It is about how to earn more, save more, and live a rich life. So watch this video till the end to know the insight from this book. First thing first, you don't need to be an expert to get rich. The second thing and the single most important thing you can do to be rich is to start early. Getting started is more important than becoming an expert. According to you, what is rich life? Please write down in the comment below. Well, let me tell you what's the author's point of view. What is rich life? According to the author, a rich life means you can spend on things you love as long as you can cut cost mercilessly on the things you don't. Here are a few key messages from this book. Getting started is more important than becoming an expert. Understanding that it's okay to make mistakes. Spending extravagantly on the things you love and cutting cost mercilessly on things you don't, also known as conscious spending. Realizing there is a difference between being sexy and becoming rich. Not living in the spreadsheet. Playing offense, not defense. Using money to design your rich life. At our age, we should be taking responsibilities for managing our money ourselves, from improvising our credit to automating our spending, and from investing the right way to planning for big purchases in our life. The vast majority of young people don't need a financial advisor to help them to get rich. We need to set up accounts at a reliable no-fee bank and then automate saving and bill payments. We need to know about few things to invest in, and then we need to let our money grow for 30 years. Having our money in two separate saving accounts and checking accounts makes money management easy. One basic way of looking at it is that your saving account is where you deposit money, and whereas your checking account is where you withdraw money. On average, millionaires invest 20% of their household income each year. Their wealth isn't measured by the amount they make each year, but by how much they have saved and invested over time. What if you could make sure you are saving and investing enough money each month and then use the rest of your money guilt-free for whatever you want? Well, you can with some work. The only catch is that you have to plan where you want your money to go ahead for time. Frugality isn't about cutting your spending on everything. That approach wouldn't last too long. Frugality isn't about cutting cost. Frugality isn't about cutting your spending on everything. That approach won't last too long. Frugality, quite simple, is about choosing the right thing you love enough to spend extravagantly on and then cutting cost mercilessly on the things that you don't love. After all that spending, saving and investing, guilt-free spending bucket contains the fun money, the stuff you can use for anything you want, guilt-free. Money here covers things like going out to restaurants and bars, taxis, movies and vacations. People will get really inspired to budget and decide to stop spending on things like appetizers with dinner, or they will buy generic cookies. That's nice, but those small changes will have very little effect on your total spending. They serve more to make people feel good about themselves, which lasts few weeks once they realize they still don't have any more money. Try focusing on big wins that will make a large, measurable change. Whether you are implementing a change in your personal finance, eating habit, exercise plan, or whatever, try making the small changes today. Something you won't even notice, and follow your own plan for gradually increasing it. In this way, time is your friend because each month gets better than the one before it, and it adds up to a lot in the end. Let me conclude this video by saying, the truth is, if you want to become economically independent, you must do something ourselves. It's time for us to become responsible for our future and start ignoring those signs that say, huge deal, 30% off. Well, here are three key lessons from this book. Credits are always good if you use them well. Choose wisely when it comes to bank accounts and investment plans. Be aware of how much you spend, how you spend it, and what you can do to improve your saving. We might be familiar with this kind of know-how about money, but still we find it difficult to be disciplined enough to get out of our situation and become rich. Hope you like this video. If you did, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you never miss an update. Please comment down below and let me know how you feel about this video, and if you have any suggestion for our channel. See you till the next video. Till then, take care. Bye.